What are the effects of stress on people's physical health? In the personality topic, we talk a bit about the different measures of personality, the different personality dimensions, and what personality is. There's actually a pretty crude distinction in popular psychology between type A and type B people. This is not a systematic theory of personality by any stretch, but according to pop psychology, the type A person tends to react in an angry or hostile way to stresses. They're generally quite competitive and impatient. For example, when a type A person gets cut off in traffic, they roll down the window and wave their arm around and abuse the other driver. The type B person tends to be much more relaxed and easygoing. They probably didn't even notice they got cut off in traffic, and even if they did, they wouldn't care anyway. They're much more easygoing. Unfortunately, for a type A person, there seems to be a link between being type A and developing heart disease. This link is likely due to their tendency to exhibit anger and hostility in response to potential stresses. This data shows that as the average anger level goes up, the risk of a coronary event also goes up. We know from research that transient mental stress and the resulting emotions can tax the heart and trigger acute symptoms of heart disease. Moller and colleagues conducted a study where they interviewed people from emergency hospitals about the triggers immediately preceding them experiencing a heart attack. They found that angry responses to disagreement triggered heart attacks in people who were susceptible. We also know that depression is related to heart disease. We know that people who are diagnosed with heart disease are at risk of depression, which is not surprising because being told you have heart disease can be pretty difficult to hear. Health-related behaviours like smoking also influence the association between depression and heart disease. If someone suffering from depression takes up smoking, there's going to be an increase to their risk of developing heart disease. Depression can also lead to dysfunction of the individual's autonomic nervous system. A dysfunctioning autonomic nervous system can affect heart rate responses to external stresses, as well as suppress the individual's immune system. Someone with a suppressed immune system is more prone to infection from various viruses and bacteria compared to those with a functioning immune system. These infections can damage the individual's heart tissue and lead to chronic heart disease. You probably already know that our immune system is the part of our body that helps to fight off infections from bacteria, viral agents, and other foreign substances. We know that stresses like crowding, shock, lack of food, and restraint, and all those methods of inducing stress covered by Cellier, reduce the immune functioning in the laboratory animals. Kai Colglasser and colleagues drew blood samples from first-year medical students 1 month before the exam period and another sample from the first day of the exams. They found that the activity of the natural killer cells in the students' blood samples declined drastically from 1 month before the exam to the time of the exam. Data consistent with this shows that at the time of the exams, students are more prone to infections because their immune system is suppressed due to the stress relating to the exams. Relating my own experience as a university lecturer, if I graph the number of medical certificates I receive each week of semester, there would be a big increase in the lead up to when assessment items are due. Some of that could be due to students wanting a little bit more time to complete the assessment, but some of it could be because students are more susceptible to infections and getting sick during times of stress. Therefore, it's important that we look after ourselves, particularly during times of stress, such as during exam period or when we have workplace deadlines. We need to ensure that we get adequate sleep and also eat well during times of stress.